Hello and welcome everyone, Tiberius here, and today's video is an edited down live stream where I solved KORP Terminal from the HackTheBox Cyber Apocalypse CTF 2024. The challenge was rated as very easy, yet I still managed to solve it using an unintended method, which also turned out to be quite a bit slower than the intended path. A solve is a solve, however, and my solution involves a technique that can be useful in certain circumstances. As always, please consider giving this video a like, subscribing to the channel, and leaving a comment with your thoughts. Now, let's get solving.
Okay, so KORP Terminal was an interesting one. If we view the page source, there's really nothing there. There's no JavaScript being loaded, style, CSS, whatever. So we can try a few things. Try admin, invalid username and password. Yeah, no. Redacted is correct. Okay, remember, I have said this on numerous occasions. If you're on a CTF, you can use or 1=1, and I used or 1=1. Okay? It did not work, all right? Or 1=1 is okay on CTFs, because a lot of the time, it is an easier way of doing stuff. In this case, it just didn't work, which I thought was good. Anyway, it turns out if you do, however, type admin with a single quote, you have an error in your SQL syntax. Interesting. Very interesting. All right, so let's send this to repeater. So it's interesting that on or 1=1 didn't work, right? But you gotta think, okay, if an or 1=1 didn't work, what does that mean? You gotta have a think. Or 1=1 doesn't work. So if it was something like this, if it was like, I don't know, select all from users where username equals admin, or 1=1, why wouldn't that work? And actually, I didn't try it. Maybe just try the limit. I actually didn't try the limit. Maybe that would have worked. No. Okay. So limit doesn't work either. So that doesn't work either. No rows in the table, potentially. But we're also assuming that there's like an and password equals this, right? We're also kind of assuming that. What if there isn't this thing? What if it just selects the password? So what if it selects the password based on the username here or whatever we put here, and then it does a password check down here in the code? That's pretty common. So that means you have to know the password, even if you're selecting the username like this, right? But it turns out what we can do, we can do some new things with this. We can, because you're all experts in SQL injection, we can use error-based injection, right? We have access to the error message. I mean, I don't know if... Yeah, there was no SQL injection in the password field. All right, so what we can do is we can go to our lovely cheat sheet and we can use something like this. There we go. We can extract information here. Look at this. So let's extract some information, chat. All right, I need to get my cheat sheet. Lovely. Let's list the databases, I guess. Schema name. All right, need to do a group concat. Okay, so the unfortunate thing here is that we are limited with what we can return. But what we can do is use a substring. We can use 0, like 20. Or not. Apparently not. I swear there is a substring option I can use here. Just give me 2 seconds, chat. 110. Okay. I think I need to start at 1 then. I guess that's weird. Okay, so we extract quite a lot of information. Can we extract 30 characters? 31, No. Okay, we can't extract 31, so we can extract 30 characters. And actually, if we get rid of these, we can actually extract a bit more, I believe. I think we can go up to 32. We can't get above 33, right? No. 33 starts concatenating stuff. Okay. So we can get 30, it's between 1 and 32, so we can extract 32 bits of information out of everything. So let's just start doing this. Oops, and let's go back, and now what we're going to do is we're going to start from 33. So there is a test database as well, but a test database is pretty common, so it's probably everything's in KORP Terminal. All right, so that's a list of tables. We want to do table name from information schema tables, where table schema equals, and then we can put our KORP terminal thing here. Right. We just get one thing, users. All right, so there is a users table in KORP terminal. All right, now we need to do the columns. So we're going to do group concat, but it's just column name. From column name, where table name, actually, we should keep table schema. Table name equals users. Hang on, I need to put an equal sign there. There we go. We get ID, username, and password. Okay. So now what we can do is we can extract username from users. We get admin. Okay, so we get admin user, and let's do password now. Okay, and we get this. So we need to do 33. And now we need to do another 32, right? So 64. Hang on. 33, 34. All right, so it does just end in a dot. So I think we have everything. Okay, so I don't think this could be cracked. Because obviously what you want to try and do is just crack this, right? I think this was quite a random password. I did give it an attempt, and maybe I just missed it. But I think this was a fairly random password that couldn't be cracked. So what can we do, chat? We cannot do regular SQL injection to bypass the login because it's doing something where we have to check the password. So what can we do? Update table? We can't do an update. MySQL doesn't support multiple statements. Any other ideas? Check test? There wasn't anything in test. You brute force this? How'd you brute force it? You cracked it? Interesting. Okay, I tried cracking it and it didn't work. Okay, all right. Well, it turns out I guess I did it wrong. Anyway, there is a nice solution to this that doesn't involve cracking the password. And that's basically based on our assumption that it is actually selecting the password here. I guess I just did this. I did this another way. So it turns out our assumptions are correct that it is basically doing a select password and it's doing the offline check. So what we can do is we can do union based injection actually. So I discovered you could do an order by. Right, so you can do an order by and you can estimate, okay, there's unknown columns. So let's just number the columns. There's less than 5, let's do 3, 2. So it is selecting one column. So that basically means this: the select statement is there is some column it's selecting here, and I guessed it was the password column. So what I did was I realized it was bcrypt, and what we can do bcrypt with, I think there's a bcrypt generator, right? Yeah, there's a bcrypt generator. So if we do password and copy that, now what we do is we do a union select and then we set the password to password, and wait a minute, I need to do random characters there. Nope, hang on. Oh, rounds 12, I think maybe rounds 12 needs to be done. Now I'm confused why this wasn't working. This definitely worked for me. There we go. I guess it checked the 12. So that was how I solved it without cracking, because you can just do a union. Yeah, for some reason my John refused to crack it. I might have accidentally missed a character, I guess. Anyway, this is a much more fun solution, I think. And if you don't use the actual password, it doesn't do it. You have to use the correct password for the hash you give it. And you have to not use a valid username. Could you explain why this one works? I can explain why this one works, yes. Let's use DB Fiddle. Show tables. All right, let's just imagine that the last name is the password here, okay? So let's imagine a login looked like this. Let's just use Ed as an example because it's easier to type. Imagine this is just a simple login. So you have to type the first name, so this is the username and this is the password, right? So everything works, okay? But in our case, what was happening was this. So what happened was the username got placed into the SQL statement and the SQL statement selected the password. And then what it did was it took the password from the results, right, the hashed password, and it compared it to whatever password we provided. So you couldn't just do a usual SQL injection like login bypass by just either doing an or 1=1 or just supplying the username and doing dashed it because it didn't do anything to the statement. What you could do with a union statement, if you do something like this, okay, you get a table where you get the results, last name, Chase, Mansfield, Guinness, and then whatever we put here. Now, if you put a dodgy username, so if you just spam whatever into here and you run this, what a lot of people don't realize is if there are no results in this first select, you still get a table generated. The union still works. If you're unioning this select and it returns nothing, but you're unioning it with this, all that matters is this has something in it, okay? So in this case, so we can control the password value. We can control what the database returns as a password value, all right? So in this case, what we can do is take the CyberChef value and run it. And remember, last name is just password, all right? And so the database thinks, even though this first name, right, is not a valid username, the database isn't checking if the username is valid. It's just checking that a password is returned by the database. And in this case, because we can do a union injection, we can return a password. And we know the value of this password hash, right? We know the password that correlates to this password hash. It's just the word password. We're basically just faking a result here. So this is another kind of SQL injection login bypass for when the password is being hashed in the database and it's being checked separately. Speechless. I mean, I'm speechless, so I did it the wrong way, but there we go. I honestly thought this was the cooler way of doing it, but...
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving it a like, subscribing to the channel, and of course, leaving a comment to let me know what you thought. See you next time.